Major Gregory Naismith Hemmings, it is the judgment of this court-martial that you be stripped of your rank and dishonorably discharged from Her Majesty's forces. Major Hemmings, you were a soldier of considerable courage and ingenuity. I only hope that in the future you will strive to regain the virtues, the trust which you have so recklessly thrown away. Do you have anything to say?
Sir, I have nothing to say. Nothing at all.
The League of Gentlemen by John Boland, adapted for radio by Mike Walker.
And Chevrolet's beautiful late cut. He's gone past Archer. I don't think Mackay can catch it.
Yeah, come in.
Good show.
What is?
Test match. Bloody Australians needed someone to teach him a lesson.
Can I help you?
Second Lieutenant Ronald Volandier?
Yeah. No. What do you want?
I want to give you some money.
You pay at the front. This is the workshop.
Oh, this isn't a repair, Lieutenant.
What the hell are you talking about?
It is ex-Lieutenant Volandier, ex-Royal Signals. Can't say I expected to find you in a backyard workshop mending radios.
Just what is it you want?
As I said, to give you some money.
What's this?
£21 notes, to be exact.
Cut in half? And what bloody good are these to me?
Tell me something.
What are you on about?
What's it like? Getting promoted from the ranks, being an officer, surrounded by people who sneer at your accent and background.
None of your bloody business.
No. Of course not. Oh, and you can collect the missing halves at 1 o'clock this Sunday. The address is on the envelope.
Hey, wait. How did you know that I was... thrown out of the army.
Good circuit, Mr. Ranger Hope. Cut 2 seconds off the lap time.
You're still missing on one of the cylinders, Jimmy. See what you can do, will you?
We need better equipment, boss, if we're ever going to compete with the big boys.
Well, we can't afford it, Jimmy. So we'll just have to make do.
Oh, this came for you.
Thanks.
What the hell?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Well, that's it for now. We'll be playing another set at 10 tonight. Thank you. Thank you.
I enjoyed your set, Mr. Portal.
You like jazz? Got a light?
Yes. Yes. Yes, I do.
And you're lying, pal.
Really?
If you like jazz, you wouldn't like that. If you like that, you wouldn't like jazz. Either way, you're out of place. In this place. What do you want? You a policeman?
Oh, no, Lieutenant. Quite the contrary.
I speak English.
Tell me something.
Maybe I will.
What was it like in Cyprus?
And maybe I won't.
Aren't you curious why I'm here, what I want?
I reckon you'll get around to it. While you're waiting, you could buy me another scotch and soda.
You're a cool one, Lieutenant. Do you want to get out of all this?
I've got another set to play.
For good. There's £20 in here, cut in half. Come to the address on the envelope, Sunday, 1 o'clock, and you'll get the matching bits. And the chance to earn a great deal more. What do you say?
I'd say, make that a double whiskey and soda.
Run, men! Come on! Keep low, we can make it! Come on, lads, we'll show them! Move! Move! Get down! God, get down! bloody death trap. Why didn't they tell us? Why didn't someone know? Why? Why? Oh, God. Hello. John Gow.
Captain, I hope I didn't disturb you. I have a proposition for you.
Brahma Cafe.
Yeah? Is this the right place?
Mr. Gower, nice of you to join us. My name is Hemmings.
You're the one who called me. You sent the envelope.
Correct. I expect you want the other half of your money. Huh.
Settle for a drink right now.
Looks like the drink has settled for you, Pally.
I'm afraid they only sell tea here, and they're not open. Now, gentlemen, since we are all here, perhaps I could have your attention.
For 20 quid? Sure. Mr. Hemmings? You do have the money.
First things first, yes. To establish my good faith. Mr. Rangerhope.
Well, got my attention, all right.
Mr. Valandia.
Thank you.
Mr. Portal.
Sweet as the bird.
Don't you mean as a bird?
I think it refers to a jazz man, Mr. Gower, something neither you nor I would understand. Ah. And there's your money.
And what do you want for it?
As I said, your attention.
Why?
Because, gentlemen, each and every one of you is a crook.
Well, I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm not staying here to be insulted.
May I introduce Captain Rangerhope, who resigned his commission after a rather large discrepancy in regimental stores had been discovered. Oh, and the good captain has also been discovered in flagrante with a private of the Royal Marines.
What?
Relax, man. None of the rest of us have anything to boast about.
Well, speak for yourself.
Or for those two Cypriot prisoners you shot in cold blood.
They were trying to escape.
And how fortunate you were able to get within a few inches of the backs of their heads.
The court cleared me.
Of murder, but you were chucked out, like the rest of us. Now, can I go on?
You've paid for your time?
Yes. Well, you'd know all about that, Lieutenant Valandia. After your distinguished service as a blackmailer.
So?
Until one of your victims killed himself and unfortunately left a note.
Get on with it, Hemmings.
As you say. Do any of you go to the cinema? If so, did you happen to see a rather clever little film that came out recently, The Killing?
I don't go to the flicks.
I did. It was rather good, I thought.
Yeah, I saw it. So?
It was about a robbery. Meticulously planned and carried out.
Well organized, I remember. It was a racetrack.
That's right. Would either of you take part in such a venture?
What? Rob a racetrack?
You're crazy.
Why ask the question?
Because I want to know. The rest of you haven't seen the film, but would you be interested in making a great deal of money?
Wait a minute. It must have taken you a bit of time, quite a bit of cash to track us down. So what do you get out of it? Some kind of sick satisfaction in getting a load of... well, whatever we are, in getting us together?
Maybe I'm a philanthropist, Lieutenant Valandia.
No, you're a crook too, Hemmings. Aldershot, 1949. You were drummed out of the service. So what do you get?
£200,000. That's a minimum for each of us.
How?
That's for later.
Couldn't be done. Maybe in America, like in the film, but not here.
Why?
It just... couldn't.
This is England.
And we're not Yanks.
These are opinions. I want reasons. Nothing? Very well. When I saw The Killing, I got to thinking, what if someone did try something similar in this country?
Anyone can think.
Yes, but then I found a target. I looked very carefully at what skills I would need to carry out this operation.
Like the film.
Exactly. I needed certain men. I looked, and I found you.
Well, I'm no expert.
You're a racing driver, Mr. Rangerhope.
What? A getaway driver?
Use your brains.
And you suppose...
just get on with it, would you, and stop bickering. I could do with a drink.
Your skill as a driver isn't the only thing we need, Ranger Hope. You, all of you, are ex-army. You know how to obey orders and how to follow a plan. And if we're going to do this, we need to regard it as exactly that,
A military operation with military discipline.
No, and you as the general, I suppose.
This is nonsense.
Well, if you're afraid, Captain.
Who said I was afraid? You've no right.
There's no gain made in this world without risk. Mr. Gower.
What have we got to lose?
About 10 years of freedom.
Look, what do you want?
I don't want to end up in prison, I'll tell you that.
Your own business, maybe, making radios, records, something. To show them you weren't just a jumped-up little corporal aping your
bet. Be careful, Hemmings.
Your record, how do you think the banks will look on a business loan? You think anyone would lend you one penny? And you, Mr. Portal, do you want to go on playing piano in cheap clubs for the rest of your life?
Maybe.
And maybe not. What do you want?
I want to see Chet Baker in New York. I want to hear Charlie Parker, Jerry Mulligan.
What's he talking about?
All right, I get your point. We all need money.
Or maybe another chance.
Maybe. And what do we call ourselves? Hemmings Irregulars?
It would make a fine title. Unfortunately, there is only one little problem with private armies. The government doesn't supply them with arms.
So?
We have to supply our own.
Arms?
We need certain tools if we're going to carry this operation through. Getting hold of them will be our first test. Can we do the job? Are we still up to it?
Where do they come from, these guns?
An excellent question, Mr. Volandia. We'll get them from the army. After all, gentlemen, I think the army owes us all something, don't you?
I like it. I like it a lot. Major, you've got style, I'll say that for you.
One in the eye for them.
How will you get away with it?
So are you all in?
Yes.
Then go back home and wait. I'll be in touch with you. And then you'll find out.
What if we change our minds?
Then you'll hear nothing more. Good day, gentlemen. Parade dismissed. Doing in my house, Ranger Hope.
If you don't want visitors, don't have your name in the phone book.
And the door was locked. How did you get here before me?
I'm a racing driver.
I thought you might have gone off with Portal. He's quite attractive, isn't he? I thought he might appeal to someone of your type.
My type, Major. My type. Why don't you pour us a drink? That's if you've got anything. From the look of this place, you must be down to your last shilling.
I've got enough. This way.
For what?
For the operation.
God, what a mess.
I got rid of the cleaner. Whiskey all right?
Looks like it had better be.
What do you want here, Ranger Hope?
I'm cautious. If I see a race with twice, three times the prize money I'm used to, I want to know why. What's the course like? What are the dangers? Thanks.
Why should I treat you any different from the rest?
Because I'm here and they're not.
Oh, you think you're pretty smart, Captain.
Since I was 15, every time I fell in love, every time I had any kind of relationship with someone, I have been taking the very real risk of going to prison for the crime of being a homosexual. So I may not be smart, but I do know how to look out for myself, Major. Well?
Well, it's a bank.
Post office bank?
High Street Bank.
And I don't know that I'm interested. Getting in is going to take hours.
Minutes, in and out.
That's not on. Not in this country.
Well, because it's never been done before.
Uh-huh.
And you're right, it just wouldn't happen in England, so why would anyone guard against it?
Snow in August.
Exactly.
It could work.
It will work, Ranger. If the planning is right, the element of surprise. More whiskey?
Yes, thanks. And call me Bill.
So, you're in?
I'm in.
I need a second in command, Bill.
Oh, I don't know about that.
What do you think about the others?
You know why you chose them.
As a team.
Volandia's a weasel. Don't trust him with money. Gower, he's got something to prove. And I didn't like the way he went pale when you mentioned guns. I wonder if you'll be able to depend on him when it comes to it.
He was good. A commander until things went bad. He lost a lot of men in an operation and got the blame.
Did he deserve it?
It was war, God knows. And what about Portil?
Ever looked closely at a wolverine, Major?
I can't say that I have.
Strange, cold eyes. You can't read them. There's nothing there. You've no way of telling what it might do. Attack you, walk away. You just don't know. Look at Portal's eyes sometime.
As you can imagine, choice was limited, but I think they'll do.
You forgot someone. Major Greg Hemmings, Royal Berkshire Regiment. Cashiered for operating beyond his orders, for using mess funds as his own, for showing a total contempt for the traditions of the British Army. What about him? Well, looking around, I would say this is his last throw. Probably borrowed from the bank, sold any shares he might have, house mortgage to the limit. How am I doing?
I'd say you're showing yourself to be a fine second in command. You've done your research. Is that what makes a good racing driver?
I wouldn't know. I'm strictly third rate. Good third rate, but if I wasn't, I wouldn't be here. You?
I once made a vow to myself. Take what you want and enjoy it today. That's why I went into the army.
And then they went and had a war, eh?
And I had a good war, and then... And then... With that feeling. You must know it. Chancing all for something. None of that. Day in, day out, commuting to work for 40 years. Everything on a moment.
All or nothing.
That sounds like a pretty good toast to me. All or nothing.
All or nothing.
This is the place.
Doesn't look much.
It's what you wanted. A little yard. Won't attract attention. Hidden from the road. Reasonably central. A friend of mine used to work on cars.
And where's the friend now?
Had to go away. There you are. Private. Nobody can see you from the street. Nothing overlooking us. Room to, do whatever you intend to do.
Well, looks big enough.
Come on, Hemmings. I'm supposed to be your 2IC. What's it for? Getaway car?
Getaway lorry.
What? Are you crazy? London streets and you want a getaway lorry.
A furniture removal van, to be exact.
Oh, right. You don't want to make it too hard for the police.
Can you drive one?
I can drive anything on this earth, Hemmings. Whether I will or not is another matter.
Think about it. Car drives away from a robbery. Police are looking all over London for it, but they can't find it.
Because you've driven the thing into the back of a furniture van.
And no roadblock in the world is going to stop a furniture van.
It could be done.
Fine.
Good night, Terry. It's my piece. Take care.
Then all that remains, Bill, is for you to steal me one.
Now?
No time like the present. Place is empty. Let's see if you've got it in you, shall we?
You think I'm scared?
I'll take the car back to the yard and meet you there. A couple of things I have to pick up. Good luck, Captain.
Well, faint heart never won fair lad.
Well, what do you think?
I like the new name. Cooperative Removals Limited.
Well, that's exactly what we're going to do, after all.
So, how did you set it up, eh?
What you don't know, you can't tell.
Listen, Hemmings. I stole that van. I'm in this now. In fact, so far, I'm the only one who's broken the law.
And?
I don't think I won't break you if I have to.
You think you could?
You think all homosexuals are limp-wristed pansies? Well, how limp-wristed is this?
Very impressive, Bill. Was it meant to frighten me?
Just a calling card, Major.
You know, I like your spirit, Captain. I really do. Buy me a pint and I'll tell you.
After I left the army, drifted round a bit, didn't find anything that appealed. Used to borrow a few quid off friends, played the horses.
Couldn't settle.
I called on an old friend one day, officer during the war, banker before, and gone back to the old job. Only when I saw him, cancer. Bloody shock, big chap he'd been, hale and all that. Now he was just eaten up. Anyhow, it turns out he was a bit of a thriller addict, and he'd been reading this book, Clean Break.
That's the one that was the film?
Yeah, and I'd borrowed it and gone back to see him and said, what you chap said, not over here. And he said, no, you're wrong.
It'd be easy, I know. In the bank I used to manage. Sent a wreath to his funeral with grateful remembrance.
Well, to your friend then.
Only, what if it doesn't come off? What then?
It'll be each for himself.
But if I'm right, if this is your last throw...
And it'll work, believe me, it has to. Look at this list.
What's it for?
Fairly obvious, isn't it?
Are we committing a robbery or starting a small war, Hemmings? Machine guns, explosives, smoke grenades.
Where would we pick them up, eh?
Guns. Well, if I had to, I don't know where I'd go. But I know who I'd ask.
Well, as you said, the army, but where? Which camp?
Ranger Hope said you'd know.
Well, because of my connection.
No, because before, you were a marksman.
Well, I could shoot straight enough if I had to. You know all about that, Major.
That's the past, Portal. I'm concerned with the present and the future. If you had to get them, where would you go?
I'd go to the seaside.
Like to have a look at your television set.
Yes, they all do on test match days.
Now, we want to buy one.
Oh, I see. Well, we have several models here that might
interest you. Can't you knock?
I did. You didn't hear, Mr. Valandier.
So, what do you want? I'm busy.
I want you to take a trip with me.
Oh? Where?
The seaside.
What? Kiss me quick, ants, ice creams. You must be joking. I'm busy.
I don't joke. This is about the job. It's work.
No, Major. This is work. This pays. And what you got so far?
You've had your £20. There's a lot more to come.
If I'm taking time off, I want paying for it.
Haven't you got any vision? Don't you trust anyone?
Shall we say 50 quid?
It's all right, but I can't see why you bother with this chicken feed.
Ah, well, that's it, you see. Chickens have to be fed, they really do. Besides, I'll be wanting a little something to spend on fish and chips and a stick of rock, won't I?
No, Lieutenant, I don't think you will.
Bloody hell, Hemmings. It's the end of the earth.
No, just Dorset.
It's not what I call a seaside.
Now stop moaning, man. Keep up.
I don't go a lot on hiking, I can tell you.
Just to the top of the rise.
We must have walked miles.
You're getting paid.
Not enough.
Oh, don't you ever stop belly aching. It's a fine day. The view is wonderful. Enjoy it.
Don't make me laugh.
Stop. Here. Get down.
There. It's a bloody army camp.
And the command training school.
Well, so that's what you're after. The guns they got in there.
They've got all we need.
Except we're out here on a hill, and they're in there, behind a fence and armed guards.
No, not armed. The rifles are unloaded. There'll be 5 rounds per man kept in the guardhouse. Besides, they're bored, fed up, and they won't expect a raid.
Maybe.
Now, what I need from you, Lieutenant...
Cut the Lieutenant, will you?
We need to deal with the alarm system.
You mean you can't do it?
Yeah, I could do it, but if we get caught... But
theoretically, if we were going to do it, take the binoculars.
Yeah, well, there's a GPO line going in. And I'd say an internal army line. Probably linking the arms stores to the guardhouse and civilian police, I won't be surprised.
If we cut them, how long would we have?
Not long enough.
Yeah, but how long?
A couple of minutes. Unless you bridge the system.
Could it be done?
Oh, yeah. It could be.
By you?
At a price.
I told you there's enough for everyone when this is over.
There's never enough. 200 in a hand, and I'll get you in and out of there so no one ever knows.
You better be right, Valandier.
When do we go?
That's my business. First thing is to get everyone together, set up a base camp.
Well, I hope it's comfortable. I don't intend to rough it, I can tell you that.
Could set up a half-decent jazz club down here.
Well, you're a bit out, Porter. You bump into Count Dracula, more likely.
Just the cellars, that's all.
Pretty big cellars.
Yes, you're right, Mr. Gower. My great-grandfather, who built the place, had the idea he'd save on rates if he built half the rooms underground.
Well, he's not far wrong. Jazz cellar or Count Dracula. You could live here with ease.
Exactly. Sit down, will you? Now, I brought you here for a couple of reasons.
Firstly, since this is going to be our headquarters, you should get to know it. Secondly, we need to get to know each other, so we can work more efficiently together. You've all got suitcases, so I assume you all agree to staying over tonight.
Uh-huh. Any particular reason why?
A very good reason.
Having a party?
Could we get on with it, please?
Oh, take it easy, Gower. You're not in the army now.
Just as well for you, Porter.
So why are we here?
Because tonight we are going to raid an army camp and steal the weapons and equipment we need for our task.
Well, back down to Dorset, then.
A raid on the army? I don't know that I like that.
Look, we're here for just one purpose. To get our hands on £1 million. Think of it. Split five ways, that's going to make each of us richer than he ever dreamed or hoped. But remember this. There's only one way to get that money, and that's to act exactly as if we were on active service. There's one leader, there's one plan, there's military discipline. And there's £1 million if we can pull it off.
Sounds okay to me, Major.
And tonight's raid will show how well we can still act like soldiers. And now, if you'll turn out the light, Bill, the slideshow can begin. So this is the view of the command training school from the Cliffwood side.
Godforsaken place.
This is the road running past the camp. We'll park the furniture van just beyond the rise there. The lane is never used at night, and the trees will screen the vehicle. Closer view of the fence where we'll enter.
Exposed, isn't it?
The long grass will hide us, though we'll need to be fast getting through.
Keep it quiet. There's the fence.
Right.
Don't touch it.
I'm not a fool.
Now here, just beyond the wire, you can see the junction box for the GPO line out. It should also control the fence and stores alarm.
Should. But what if it doesn't?
Are you finished yet?
You think you can do better, Ranger Hope?
Just get on with it, will you?
Hold on. It's spaghetti in here. Do you like spaghetti?
Oh, for God's sake.
I think that's it.
You think?
Well, you just have to take a chance with me, big boy. Give him the signal.
Once Volandia has rerouted the alarms, we cut the fence and make for these huts. Here.
And the sentry?
Timed rounds, every half hour. Regular as clockwork.
Oh, that bloody stuff is sharp. Right, keep low. Go. Stop. Christ. The sentry. What the hell?
The others will be coming. They won't know. They'll blunder right into him.
Have to make sure they don't. I'll do it, don't worry.
No, no, can I?
You've got a better idea.
Hey, Duckworth! Get back here!
Coming, Sarge!
Once the alarm is disabled, Volandia and Ranger Hope will join the main party. And we'll proceed to the two sheds at the end of the first row.
Just padlocks?
Yeah.
No individual alarms?
Well, this is the army, no, of course not. The only problem might be...
Keep it down, for God's sake. They hear us now, we're finished.
Not once we've got a few of these little beauties. Sterling. Lovely gun.
Gower, are you in yet? We are now. Right.
It's vital that no one overloads themselves. We've a good half mile back to the truck and some of the equipment weighs in pretty heavy. So, look at your lists, take just what's on them, and remember, in fast, out fast.
How much ammo for the pistols?
It's on the list.
I can't read the bloody list. It's dark. You want me to switch a light on?
Just a couple of boxes. Everyone ready?
Ready. Yep.
A couple of minutes before the guard is clear. Want a smoke?
I've got my own.
Anna, have one of these.
Aren't you worried about the smell?
Wind's in our favour.
Bit slack, isn't it? Fag on the job.
Sweet Afton. The cigarette of choice for our friends in the IRA. Make sure you leave the butt behind.
Well, well, well. For a stuffed shirt, you're really quite smart, Major Hemmings.
It might be worth you remembering that, Porter.
Torch from the other hut. They're ready.
All of you must be familiar with the route back to the van. It'll be dark. There's no moon.
And no guards.
There shouldn't be, as I said.
And if there are?
We disable them.
I won't stand for killing, you know that. Not our own people.
Your own people court-martialed you, Gower. What do you owe them, eh?
Not them, me. I've seen enough unnecessary killing, Porter. And unlike you, I don't like it.
All right, that's enough. This is the lane as you approach from the camp. Learn the landmarks.
One tree looks pretty much like any other to me.
Once we reach the lorry, Ranger Hope and I will use the cab, the rest of you in the back, stowing the weapons. And if we get stopped, for God's sake, try and look like removal men.
Oh, that's it. I can't load anymore.
What the hell?
You've heard of something?
Nah. The governor told us to act like removal men, and I reckon it's me bleeding tea break.
Well, that's it. Everything except one pack of gun cotton explosive.
Well, who was that supposed to be?
Volandia, that was you.
Well, I must have dropped it. It don't matter, does it?
You think it doesn't matter?
You want to make something out of it?
Just remember, you drop 50,000 quid when we leave the bank, and it's coming out of your share.
Nah. Got you there.
Did he? We'll see.
Some planning. You never mentioned the rain, Major. Drives like a pig.
Who stops pigs?
You reckon we'll get away with it?
The guns, of course. They'll think it's the Irish.
But Andy didn't like it when you made him look a fool.
Does it matter?
It might.
Nah. He wants the money.
That's what I thought. Now I'm not so sure. Maybe he just discovered something he wants more than the money.
I'll take my chances against him. Against any of them, Bill. That includes you.
Might be worth a try. Just to see.
See what?
If you could pull the trigger when it counted.
Well, maybe we'll find out one day.
Still, we did it tonight.
We did. And they work well together, whatever their motives.
You think they'll do?
I'm not worried about them. It's getting a car into this van that concerns me. We're not going to be able to drive it up the tailboard.
We need some kind of ramp we could carry with us. Only we won't have time or space to reload it once the car's aboard.
So, we leave it behind us. It'll make a roadblock.
Oh, sure. While we take the time to get it in position and...
No. We fill it with incendiary material, set it alight. That'll keep them busy.
Huh? That's strategic thinking, Major. Makes me wonder why they threw you out.
Yep, slow down. Don't get too close to anyone.
You can get as close as you like to that. Rolls Silver Cloud. Best damn car in the world.
Maybe after this is over, I'll buy one. After all, we deserve the best.
Hey,
there's coffee in the kitchen or beer for those who want it.
It's all right.
For something stronger.
Hey, Gower, you had a hip flask and you didn't offer it round. I thought we were supposed to be a team.
I can still manage not to mix drink and work, Portal. But if you want to talk now...
Yeah, cheers.
Oh, that's good.
No, you were all good. Congratulations. We've got the guns.
We've got the men.
And before long, we'll have the money, too.
How long, Major?
Soon, that's all I'll say. We've got a lot to do yet, so if any of you want to take a rest, there are beds available. Otherwise, go back to your lives until you hear from me, and be ready to move at an instant's notice.
Yes, sir.
Captain Gow, will you stay behind, please?
Uh-oh, called up in front of the CO.
Always loved the smell of ground coffee beans.
Never really drunk the stuff.
More of a hard liquor man, eh, Mr. Gow? Don't go for percolators. All you need is a jug and freshly boiled water.
Are you worried I won't be able to stay off this stuff? That I'll jeopardize the operation?
Will you?
No. I'll be okay.
Good. That's fine.
You'll take my word?
Yes.
As an officer and a gentleman?
As a man who knows what it's like to be under fire. Now, I need your help. When we go in, we'll need... two explosions.
No casualties.
No, of course not.
Because I have to tell you, Major, I don't like all these guns.
We're thieves, Gower. We need to be armed, or some damned fool is sure to have a go at us, but you can trust me on this. No killing.
All right. But if you break your word, Major, I'll kill you. And that's a promise. Now, what do you want?
The bank has two alarm systems, both worked electrically off the mains. There are also a number of alarm buttons inside. Touch any of them, and all the exits from the place are automatically shuttered by steel doors. And you can see two external alarm bells. There's also a direct phone line to the police station from the manager's office, which is the third window on the first floor.
We couldn't get up there in time to stop him. Pretty problem. you have the answer?
Yeah, we fix all the systems from the outside. That's your job. Isolate the bank.
By cutting the phone and electric lines before they go inside. It could be done. But we need to be in...
GPO inspection chamber under this manhole. Electricity under that one on the corner.
If we cut the lines, the alarm will go off anyway.
So will 500 uppers. The whole area will be blacked out. It'll be chaos.
Set the charges by timer.
That's the idea.
Probably too risky. Timing might go wrong. It'd need to be a transmitter.
You could do that?
Yes, Major.
Then I want you to prepare the charges back at HQ, all right?
Fine. Are you coming back?
No, I thought I'd try to educate my musical taste.
Well, Major?
Still sounds like a racket to me.
Older generation. So, since you don't like the music, why are you here?
Can you ride a motorbike?
Used to be able to, why?
Well, when we leave...
But after the job?
I'm going to need a rear guard. When the van drives away, we'll want backup in case anyone picks up on us.
Well, what do I do then? Politely request them to desist?
No, you make them desist.
I shoot them?
If you have to.
This might be interesting.
Now, look... Violence is the last thing we want.
Really? I thought getting caught was the last thing we wanted. Don't worry. I'll do it. No shooting unless I have to. You can trust me.
Ah. Hello, Bill. Didn't see you there.
Evening, Major.
I didn't know you were a member of this club.
Martin's promised to lead me through the thickets of modern jazz. Can I buy you a drink?
No, I have to go. How's the work on the van going?
Why don't you pop round and have a look? Tomorrow afternoon, say.
Yes. Yes.
May I ask you a personal question about your clothes? Is it part of publicity to wear rather exotic clothes?
Well, I represent a very glamorous profession.
Can you turn that off, Volandier, if you don't mind?
I dress accordingly.
All right.
If I were...
Thank you. Now, can you send as easily as you can receive?
Of course. What is it you want?
Two transmitters.
Go on.
One powerful enough to jam police broadcasts.
Why not blow up Scotland Yard? It'd be easier. Is jamming part of the plan?
We'll call it additional precautions.
I'll call it what the hell you like. It's no money out of my pocket.
Well, it could put a lot of money into your pocket. Can you do it?
Over a limited area, yeah. Yeah. It could be done.
It'd have to run for an hour, no more. After that, it won't matter. We'll be well away.
And a second?
Short range, 100 yards, no more, just to set off a couple of detonators.
Fine. Yeah. It'll cost.
Well, can't you find the equipment? You've got enough around this place.
It'll cost.
For God's sake, man, you'll be rich.
I estimate about 50 quid, Major. For parts. You can have my labour for free.
All right.
How long have I got?
3 days.
That should do it. Hold a tank now.
All it needs is to hold a Hillman Husky.
Why not use something with a bit of power?
Won't be noticed. There's a million of them around. Muddy the number plates and who'll remember a Hillman?
Makes sense.
Fine. Then I think everything is ready, Mr. Ranger Hope. Shall we go?
You didn't seem to approve yesterday, Major.
Who you consort with is your business. Different tastes.
Not yours, eh?
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Constable.
I didn't know anyone was working here. Thought the place was empty.
Just rented it for a couple of days. Needed some repairs to one of our trucks.
Of course, sir. Well, I won't keep you. Now I know the place is occupied, I'll keep a closer eye on it.
Yes, thank you, Constable.
No trouble. No trouble at all, sir.
What if you'd asked to see the HGV license?
He didn't. But it points out one more lesson. The longer we take, the more chance of discovery. I want you to get hold of the Hillman by tonight. Check it'll drive in the back of the van.
Then
we gather everyone together at the house and start training in earnest.
The front door, gentlemen.
That's our way in.
Bloody hell. You couldn't have chosen a less obvious place, could you? Park Lane?
That's the point, Volandia. Once the area gets clogged up with traffic, everything stops, except us.
That's what we're going to do, is it?
Bring central London to a halt. This is the banking hall, left and right. The door, you see, opens onto the staff area. There's a corridor which leads to the assistant manager's office. It also leads to the main safes. It's down this corridor that money is brought in. And on the first Friday of each month, it can be anything up to 2 million.
2 million? You said...
In this shot, you can see the door ajar. The corridor is wide enough for the trolley and two men, and that's the usual escort. Yes, Ranger, I hope I said one. That's guaranteed. Any more?
And that's a bonus.
The van arrives between 11 and 10 past. Inside the bank at 5 past, the manager and 4 assistants take the empty trolley to the van. They escort the trolley back across the pavement. And once it's inside the bank, 2 of these men go back to their desks.
They think they're safe inside.
Yeah, it's their weak point. A bank full of customers, a bank full of smoke. The lights go out suddenly, 2 huge bangs in the road, and men in gas masks waving guns.
Yeah, they won't know what hit them.
Smoke grenades. Turn the place into a pea super.
Yeah, that's why we will need to be absolutely sure of our movements, and we will. We'll go over them until each one of us can do his job blindfolded.
Hold on. Why not take the money on the pavement? We're going to create smoke and confusion out there.
Because the armoured van doesn't leave until they see the money into the bank. We don't want to deal with security men, just a few soft bankers.
It suits me. Let's make it as easy as possible.
Yeah. Just remember what I said, Major. Everyone, no violence.
You know, Gower, for someone who lost over 20 men in a stupid attack and came out alive...
What are you saying, Portell?
He's not saying anything. Violence will not be necessary as long as everyone knows their jobs. And by next Friday, when we drive that Hillman Husky down Park Lane, they will.
Hit someone now and hope bloody
it's all right. It's going to be fine.
It's too bloody busy. We'll never
mind. No, there's the van, parked where it should be.
Where's Ranger Hope?
He's getting out. He's on the move.
Good. Okay, it's coming up now. Ready with the transmitters?
Ready.
You should see Portal on the bike any
time. Got him. Outside the bank. The money's going in. He's following.
We're too early.
We can't slow down.
Yeah. We must just second. Come on. Come on.
Ranger Hope's inside. We have to go now.
The armored van's moving. Quick, get in there. Go up.
Blow the electrics now.
No.
For God's sake.
There's a kid standing over the manhole.
What the hell? Blow it anyway.
Not a kid. I won't hurt.
He's gone. Now. Right. Masks on. Transmitters.
Going.
Smoke grenades.
Go, go, go!
Move out!
Stone grenades! Right, down on the ground, everyone. Everyone down, and you won't get hurt.
Down now. Down now.
Everyone down.
Start the count.
Move, you! Move, move, move!
I won't. Chris.
Bloody manager!
Get the police, someone!
Well, shut up, you! No, not too hard! Not too hard!
25 seconds.
Push it.
Damn it! Harder!
Mind the bag!
Move it! Move it! All of you, stay on the floor and you won't get hurt. It's not your money, it's the bank's. Don't take any risks for their money.
Get it out!
More smoke! More smoke!
Open the doors!
Let's go! Let's go!
We'll be leaving a man behind to cover the doors. Anyone emerging before 5 minutes have passed will be shot. Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for this interruption. Normal service will be resumed as soon as possible.
55 seconds.
Fill your glasses, gentlemen. You're rich, each one of you. £200,000.
Well, give or take a few, Bob.
Just as long as Volandia didn't drop anything this time.
Well, if I did, it was yours.
I never saw so much money. It's... Look at it.
Yeah, I know what you mean. It's crazy. It's absurd. Like, it's like finding an elephant in your drawing room.
Well, touch it. Smell it. It's ours. All of it. Every pound of it. Raise your glasses, then, to the League of Gentlemen.
The League of Gentlemen!
I listened to the news. The police say it was the most professional raid they've ever encountered. No clues.
There you are.
The manager's in hospital. Fractured skull. His condition is critical.
So? Stupid old fool. Look, I had to do it. There's no choice.
Yes, right, Gower. There was no choice.
There's always a choice. And you made it, Portal.
Like you did. At least I only injured one old man.
How many did you kill looking for glory? What does that make you, Gower, a bloody Welsh angel?
You got a hell!
No, you go and cool down, Gower. Take a few minutes, think it over, relax. It'll be all right, you'll see.
Just so long as I don't have to smell port ale.
He'll come round. And if he doesn't...
I always wondered about him.
Yeah, have another drink, relax. We've got to stay here for at least a day to count and divide the cash, so we might as well enjoy ourselves.
Well, let's have some music.
More jazz.
Why not?
Yeah, well, why not?
I know you don't like me, Hemmings.
I didn't say.
You don't have to say. What did you do after you met me in Portland at that club?
I came home.
And?
Yes. I had a shower.
Because you hate someone who's different. Have you ever thought that maybe you're different too?
I'm no pervert, Richard.
But you are different. In our own ways, each one of us. Failed gentlemen. Have you thought of that? Not one of us has been able to fit in. There's something not quite right with all of us. And that's why we're here. With £1 million. Snow in August.
Hemmings. He's dead.
What?
I warned you.
Who's dead?
The manager. It was on the news. He died. He just died.
Look. No.
Shut up!
Look, that was my damn set.
I told you, didn't I, Hemmings? If anyone dies, then you die. I told you.
Oh, come on, Gower. You've got no quarrel with the Major. I hit the manager. If you like, I killed him.
I'll get to you, Port Hill. But him first. He's the leader. He takes responsibility. That's how it is in the army, right? Right, Hemmings?
For God's sake, Gower.
Yes, for God's sake.
I always thought he had it coming.
You didn't have to kill him.
I didn't have to, but I did. Saved your life, Major Hemmings.
What are we going to do with the body? Won't somebody miss him?
You know, Volandia, old man, I have a feeling there's no one would miss any of us.
There's a big garden outside, lots of room. Stick him in a bunker overnight.
Well, now we'll win, I suppose.
What?
Well, makes each of us another 50,000 better off.
You know, Volandia, I think I'm beginning to like you.
I think you like this. All of us, Portal. Don't you ever think that one day it'll be you on the wrong end of the gun?
Oh, nothing will happen to me, Major. It never does. Now, if no one has any objections, I think I'll turn in. After all, it's been quite a day, hasn't it?
Deserting, Lieutenant Volandia? Bit of a letdown, eh? Perhaps your brother officers weren't so far wrong when they treated you like a jumped-up gutter snipe. Come on, march.
You can't make me.
We've a dead man downstairs. What difference would another one make? Move.
Now look, I was just taking a walk. I couldn't sleep.
So you decided to get some exercise carrying bundles of notes upstairs. I've changed my mind, Volandia. I don't think I like you after all.
You'll like him a good deal less when you see the little surprise he left for us wired to the front door. Now that wasn't me.
Shut up!
Gun cotton. I imagine that when we heard him drive away, we were meant to run downstairs and open the front door. And boom! Goodbye, League of Gentlemen. Hello, police. Bodies found, case solved, and Lieutenant Volandia home and free.
Nice plan.
Shame that someone disabled the car engine.
You bastard!
No, I think you've got that wrong. You're the bastard, right, Major?
He's the traitor. And you know what happens to traitors? He wouldn't.
Oh, God! Oh! You can't! Oh!
Only two hits out of six. You should put some time in on the range, Major.
Have a drink. I think we should get the hell out of here now.
Sounds like good sense, Bill. Let's grab some bags and head for the hills.
You think you're going to leave me to clear up this mess?
The responsibilities of leadership.
No, Major. No, you're staying
the
here.
The pistol's empty, Major. Put it down.
You can't just...
It's the bloody phone.
Well, I'd better answer it, hadn't I?
Yes?
Gregory Naismith Hemmings.
Who wants to know?
Superintendent Wheatlock, Metropolitan Police.
Police?
No, no, no!
You're trying to fool us, Hemmings. Yes?
You're surrounded by armed officers. You've got no chance.
Let's see, shall we?
Easy! They're out, all right.
Hemmings.
This is Hemmings.
Don't cut me off. Listen to me.
Go on.
I don't want trouble. You're in a hopeless position. My men are armed, as you know. You can't get away, any of you. I don't want bloodshed. Come out now. Give yourselves up.
Look, I don't know what you're talking about. This is absolutely...
You know what I'm talking about. The bank job yesterday. Look, use your brains. They said you used to be smart. Be smart now, Hemmings.
They knew. How the hell did they know? Who was the traitor?
Does it matter anymore?
It matters to me!
Worried about the quality of your man management, Major. I think it's a bit late for that now.
So what do we do?
Well, I'm not standing around here waiting.
Make a run for it.
What else is there? Are you game, Major?
Oh, would you find our company compromising? You go. I'll cover for you. Give me some ammunition. What's this? Noble rearguard action.
Oh, you think they'll give you a medal for this?
Go through the back. It's overgrown. You might have some kind of chance. Look, maybe you don't believe me, but I... Just go.
Come on, Bill!
Yes?
Are you coming?
I'll make a bargain with you.
The police don't bargain. You're in no position to make a deal.
You don't think so? We've got ammunition, grenades, half a dozen men who are experts with small arms. How many of your people do you want to lose?
Go on, then.
Who betrayed us?
No one.
Listen to me, who?
I'm telling you, no one.
I do mean it. Yeah! Still there?
Are you crazy?
Your choice.
All right. John Babbage.
John? Who the hell is...
A 7-year-old boy who collects car and lorry numbers. He was there yesterday and noted down the number of your furniture van. It was interesting. A Birmingham registration, not London. He thought it was worth keeping.
No, that's stupid. I don't believe you. There's no connection.
Well, there is. Do you remember a young copper you talked to about your van? Said he'd keep an eye out for you. Well, he noted the number down. Dead keen, these probationers. And he also noted the number of your own car. So if you're looking for the traitor... Are you coming out? You haven't got a chance.
Do you know, Superintendent, I rather think you're right. Well, one can at least die like a gentleman.
The League of Gentlemen by John Boland was adapted for radio by Mike Walker. Hemmings was played by Jonathan Coy, Ranger Hope by Mark Benton, Portal by Raymond Coulthard, Volandier by Adam Cotts, and Gower by Mark Lewis Jones. Superintendent Wheatlock was Alistair Findlay and the constable Thomas Arnold. Other parts were played by members of the company. The director was Toby Swift.